Understanding your language. What would I want to be remembered by? It is such a vague question, but with numerous possibilities. I went from the girl who is trying to figure out who she is, to recreating herself every day. Whenever I was younger, I would talk to anyone that would listen to me. Everyone said I had an old soul. But me being so literal, it made me think God should have fixed me up somewhere, because I was a 70-year-old person in a 5-year-old's body. My mom would get so mad because people would really tell me their life problems. I feel like as I grew older, I became a person that always wanted to see people do better. That's maybe why I became bolder in my approach to things. Certain things would come out of my mouth, and I wouldn't even notice that it was bad until it was already out in the atmosphere. I was always told if your tongue was correct, people could take your advice in one or two ways. They would abuse it or use it, but don't feel beat up about it with either way it goes. It says in the Bible, life and death is in the power of the tongue. So that means I cannot let negativity come out of my mouth. When you come into the world, you already have your way of viewing it, whether it is genuine, morbid, or snarky. In my years, I look at things straightforward, so that makes me a very inquisitive person. I've recently called this the London language, and very few can translate it or put it into question sentences. That's maybe why I don't have that many friends like I used to in the beginning of the year. But to be honest, I personally feel like it's an honor to understand the language. At the end of the day, I would say that I have learned to just be yourself, learn who you are, and find your music and your rhythm, and maybe you can learn your own language. I feel with God on my side, I can conjugate any verb that comes in my way, and I would be successful any way that I go. I have found my language, and I hope that you find yours.